phrase, and God saw that it was good. As each piece of creation came into being by the word of God, over and over, God deemed things as good. But in Genesis 2:18, we read, "The Lord God said, 'It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper for him.' For this cause, man shall leave his father and his mother and cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Consequently, they are no longer two, but one flesh." From the very beginning, God has blessed and ordained marriage as a covenant between two people. It's not a contract which states, if you do this, I'll do that. Rather, it's an agreement between two people that will commit themselves to one another, leaving no escape clauses or loopholes. You have come to be made husband and wife. Will you join hands and repeat these vows with me? Andrew. I, Andrew, take you, Amanda. To be my wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. To this I pledge myself, truly with all of my heart. Amanda. I, Amanda, take you, Andrew, to be my husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live. To this I pledge myself, truly with all of my heart. May I have the rings? It's long been customary for the vows you have just given to be sealed with the exchanging of rings. These rings not only symbolize the pledge today, but also the purity and the completion of the love you share. As these rings are made of pure and valuable metal, may your lives be marked with purity and a love toward one another. The rings have no beginning and no ending. May they always remind you of the never-ending love that you have for each other and that you pledge today. Life may momentarily separate the two of you in body, but these rings you wear will remind you that you are never separated from the heart and the mind of the one who loves you. Andrew, if you would take Amanda's ring. Just on her left hand. Repeat after me. This ring I give you. In token and in pledge. Of our constant faith. And steadfast love. Amanda. Please repeat after me. This ring I give you in token and in pledge of our constant faith and steadfast love. Excuse me. Jesus Christ, who caused light to shine out of the darkness at the beginning of creation, made this claim. He said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. You are the light of the world, so let your light shine before men." The two outside candles behind you have been lighted to represent your lives to this moment. They're two distinct lights, each capable of doing and going its own separate way. To bring joy and radiance into your home, there must be a merging of these two flames into one. As the center candle cannot be divided, let not your lives be divided, but instead be a testimony of a home as Christ gives you light. Thank you.
travel goes bad. Life I live comes from life I have. I close my eyes and I dream of my butterfly coming down to rescue me. She's my butterfly.
Marriage is a great covenant instituted by the creator and sustainer of life. His plans for us are perfect. His design for marriage far outweighs man's understanding and comprehension of what marriage can be. During your marriage, you will find everybody has marriage advice for you. Everybody will have marriage advice for you. And I found some that I want to share with you today. Amanda, this is for you. Ava, little girl, age 8, says this: one of you should know how to write a check. Because even if you don't, even if you have tons of love, there are still going to be bills. And Andrew. Aaron, a little girl, age 8, says this: don't forget your wife's name. That will mess up the love. And be a good kisser. Because it might even make your wife forget that you never take the trash out. Andrew and Amanda, some wedding advice that I leave you that was given to me on my wedding day. And it says this. It's 1 Corinthians 13. And instead of saying love is patient, love is kind, it goes like this. Andrew is patient. Andrew is kind. Or Amanda is patient. Amanda is kind. They do not envy. They do not boast. They are not proud. They are not rude. They are not self-seeking. They are not easily angered. They keep no records of wrongs. They do not delight in evil, but rejoice with the truth. They always protect, always trust, always hope, always perseveres. Andrew never fails. Or Amanda never fails. Throughout your marriage, you will have mountaintop and valley experiences together. And that's just part of life. But if you strive to live your life as a life of love for your spouse, the valleys won't seem so deep and dark, and the mountaintop experiences will be far greater than you ever could have imagined. Let's pray. Father God, creator of marriage, we acknowledge that without your grace, no promise is sure. Strengthen Andrew and Amanda with the gift of your Spirit so that they may fulfill the vows they have taken in your presence. Keep them faithful to each other. Fulfill them with such a love and joy that their love for one another is obvious to those around them. May you guide them all the days of their lives. We pray this in your name. Amen. You two have come before us expressing your desire to be husband and wife. You have shown your love and affection by joining hands, have made promises of devotion to each other, and have sealed these promises with the giving and the receiving of rings. Andrew, let me kiss your bride. Family, friends, and loved ones, I count it an honor to be the first to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Wagner. Thank you.